What is up, guys, and welcome back to a brand new video. Today we are tackling F1 Manager 23 once again, this time for the Canadian Grand Prix. Check out the last episode if you haven't seen it already. We had some pretty decent points at the Spanish Grand Prix, and we are looking to continue that form again today with hopefully two cars, because we put some big boy upgrades on the car in the last episode, but only on Lando Norris's side. Today we'll hopefully get those components over to Oscar as well. And we also have some other upgrades in the pipeline as well. So it could be a big day of upgrades, potentially. Let's have a look. We have chassis coming in. We have a new suspension coming in, all in time for the Canadian Grand Prix. So we're going to be spending a lot of moolah on manufacturing components. Speaking of, underfloor and side pods are well underway. And yeah, we're going to have to actually make a decision on which one we do next. Unless we emergency manufacture.
No! God, please, no! No! No!
Anyway, we have an email which requires urgent response. You've noticed some tension between Oscar Piastri and his race engineer, Bono. I'm not exactly sure why they're not getting along, but I know that this can have an impact on the driver's morale, on-track performance, so I thought I'd let you know. May want to speak with them. Intervening may just make things worse if they're not strong communicators. Bono and Piastri having beef? That is not in either of their characters. Both of these guys are pretty chill dudes. What could they possibly have beef over? The ashes? Oh my word. Okay, what do we do? Do we acknowledge and risk losing affinity between the two? Oscar gets a bit more aggression. Oscar loses morale. Or do we intervene? Tensions may improve or tensions may worsen. Either way, we lose affinity. Intervene. Bono is a great communicator. I think we intervene. It looks like things could improve if we do intervene. So we're all adults here. We're all professionals. Hopefully they can get along. Here's the tension. I don't think the tension has improved at all. I think the situation is more likely to resolve itself naturally. So all we can do is wait for now. I'll let you know when the two seem to be getting along again. Oh dear. All right, time to fire Oscar. That's how we solve the problem.
Yes! Yes! Yes!
Acknowledge. Oh, well, we have to acknowledge. Very good. Very good. All right. Suspension components that we've been designing in the background is ready to hit the manufacturing stage and go on the car. Better in medium speeds. We overtake another team and brake cooling gets better. And weight improves. Very good. How long will this take to make? 8 days. If we rush, 5 days. It'll be ready for race day, but by that point, it'll be parc fermé. Emergency one and rush the other, we could do. Emergency manufacture. Okay, that is done. Now we can get to work on the second one. And by rushing that, we can get that on in 5 days' time and begin work on the chassis. Boom. Factory level 3, we'll be able to unlock more projects, which I can't wait for, to be honest. 2.3 mil. It might be okay if we get some more money in. Design is complete on the chassis, meaning we are clear of engineers here and can begin work on new projects. But we're still waiting on manufacturing for other things. Suspension will be done in 3 days. All right, let's fast forward time. All right, now we can begin work on the chassis. These things take ages from what I remember. 10 days at normal speeds. Rushed is 7. Emergency, oh my God, 2 mil. Guys, chassis upgrades are huge. I am going to emergency manufacture this. Those gains are too hard to ignore. 2.2 mil. We're down to 61k. Oh my word. Spend money to make money, chat. We're living life on the edge. Helipad is done. We get more cash if we meet the sponsor objectives, which I'm pretty confident we might be able to do this weekend, as long as we don't bin the car. All right, guys. We do have a bit of a dilemma with Lando. He probably will need to take a penalty of sorts for the ERS this weekend. So maybe, just maybe, we put the new chassis on Oscar this weekend. Yeah, two drivers in Q2. Easy, easy money. I'm actually going to risk and say two drivers will get Q3 this weekend. I'm doing it. I'm confident. I think we've got pace. Okay. There is a lot riding on this weekend. It's a street circuit. All the champions. The barriers are nice and close. It could all come undone this weekend and we could get fired if it goes wrong. With that said, to the race weekend! There we go, guys. That is practice three. Overall, marred with a little bit of reliability. Lando retired at the end of practice two with a terminal gearbox issue. In practice three, it was Oscar who had a terminal ERS issue, but he was just left in the garage and couldn't return out again. So unfortunately, we missed out on like 20 or 30 minutes of practice three for Oscar. And only 93% setup confidence. So not ideal, but could be worse. Overall, we have decent preparation to start this weekend. And with new parts for both cars, hopefully we're challenging. Oh, crikey. Let's swap out these bits then. Brand new engine for Oscar this weekend. Final one of the season before we have to take grid penalties. That is what is on our doorstep. Those grid penalties are looming for McLaren. There's no getting around that. Car parts. Orlando, 94% engine. It's only done one race weekend. ERS is in the mud. We might have to take penalty on that. But I don't exactly want to. Gearbox, 72%. That should be fine. I may take this for the race, depending on where we qualify. Here we go. Time for quali. Three sets of tires for Lando. Oscar only has two, unfortunately. Yeah, we're gonna blame not getting one of these tires out of the way in practice for that. But we move. Okay, let's do a banker with Oscar on mediums. Get that out of the way. We only did the one run for Oscar last time out, and that hurt us a little bit. P3 on a harder tire. Let's go. Send Lando out nice and early. Little push, deploy. Tires are a little bit cold. Lando goes. P5. 1.3 seconds off. I'm going to try two flying laps. Let's try with Oscar first. Where does Oscar go? No improvement. No improvement for Oscar. Interesting. I thought we'd have more pace than this. I think Norris did just improve. We're going to send him to do this lap again. Back-to-back push laps. Battery will be a little bit low. We don't have any other choice here. Battery is done. It did improve. The Piastri's out. Ah, come on. New parts and everything. Wow. 1.3 seconds off Verstappen. I thought we'd be cooking this weekend. I really did. I thought this would be where Oscar would be, minimum. And I thought this is where Orlando would be, at least. It's not gone that way. Gonna have to hope for rain. What the hell? I did put the new parts on. All right, time for Q2. All right, here we go. 15-0 was what we did. Q1? No, must have been a 13-0. Instantly quicker. Love to see it. I'm going to try and time our run to get DRS. So it might be time to go for Orlando. Red Bull will be in the way. Doesn't get in the way. Thank you. Science on a purple lap. Green, green. That's more like it. Oh, actually, don't run out of fuel, please. Save the tires for Q3. Lovely job. It would be nice to try and get some slipstream going off of some quicker cars. It might make a difference. But yeah, Q2, a lot more favorable for us. It's a shame Oscar couldn't clear the bar because I feel like he'd probably be more competitive too. All right, Q3 time. Purples. Yeah, that's a terrible lap. All right, here we go. Clear run. New tyres for Norris.
There's a car.
Oh no, oh no, oh no, oh no. Finish the lap, finish the lap, finish the lap before red flag. Come on. Finish the lap before red flag. Okay, we got it in. P6. IRL, that would have been a red flag. We may be able to get Russell. May be able to get Russell. But I think I might save the final set of softs for the race. They might be more useful to us. That's what I'm going to do. Okay. Beaten by Verstappen. Can Stroll beat us? Nope. He's dawdling. What about Gasly? Gasly might improve. doesn't improve. We were going to get beaten by Verstappen anyway. In the end, we save a set of tyres. Q2 was our best time. 12.5, we might have been up there with Russell, but that's life. If you guys have like suggestions about like how I can be more consistent on our qualifying runs, like qualifying seems to be a little bit of an enigma. Sometimes we're really crap, sometimes we're not. And I'm talking from Q1 to Q2 or vice versa. Some sessions we will be randomly a lot quicker and I don't really know why. I'm sure there's explanations, whether it be track grip, rubber, track temperature, weather, slipstream, who knows? A bunch of things. But we're ready for the race and apparently there's some rain. Let's take that into consideration. Rain is coming around lap 30. So let's factor that into the strategy. Probably mediums, if we want to go aggro on those. Yeah, I think mediums is perfect. For Oscar, maybe a little bit more of a stretch to be competitive for Oscar to the rain on mediums. I do wonder if maybe softs. It may even take until we get to like 33, 34, 35 until we need to switch to inters. I think it's a fairly short pit lane time around here. A pit stop before rain may not be the worst thing in the world. I mean, we kind of cooked on our strategy last episode with the 3 stop for Piastri. We could be cooking again. Pit lane loss is not a lot of time, to be honest. And safety car is just no time at all. Always make a pit stop under safety car here. Probably risky. It probably is quite risky doing this. We could still go softs here if we want to. If we want to make a mad undercut, if that's what we want to do. So I think medium is probably the most flexible and safe bet for both cars.
We're moments away now at the Canadian Grand Prix.
Here we go. It's all on the line here.
Lights out and away we go.
Push, push, push. I didn't go attack mode off the start for Lando. That is a rookie error.
Confirm.
Tires.
An overtake is available.
Confirm.
A lot of people on softs. A lot of people on softs. We actually might gain a lot here. Maybe the AI have figured out that a 2-stop or a 1-stop before rain is quicker. They usually are pretty smart this year. But we could potentially outsmart the AI if they lose a ton of time making a pit stop. Who knows? Better we can look after our tyres, the better. Gastro going backwards into the hairpin, chilling. Lost places for both cars, but we're on mediums and everyone is on softs. Leclerc could be cooking here. Leclerc is definitely going to the rain period without a pit stop. Still staying with, which is good. Don't need to worry about fuel because it's going to rain.
Now we're approaching turn 2. It's certainly inviting.
Good move. Can't fault that. Losing so much on the straight. That's what our drivers wanted. Our drivers wanted high aero, relatively speaking, for Canada. If we go against our drivers' wishes, they end up being pretty slow anyway. Oh, DRS here. Looks like they're re-overtaking. Very good. Oh my word, Alonso's down here. Is he all right? We're kind of just waiting, hoping that we don't lose too much time to the leaders while we're on our mediums running long here. At times, 18.3, we are considerably slower than all the leaders, so that's not great. We have pit stop behind by the time the rain comes. Lovely stuff. And we're through. Should be double DRS as well. See you later, mate. Let's run away, please. You think I'll get ninth? I think maybe top 5. I think top 5 is potentially on the cards. Go away. Don't want to drag you along. You're the worst. Ocon is so annoying in this series. Nice. Pick him off, mate. One by one. Let's have a look and see what the expected strategies are from the AI. Ooh, pit window closes on lap 30 and the rain is coming like 30 or just after. I wonder if they'll stretch. They will be suffering big time on their tires by then. See, we are nearly a pit stop behind to the race leader. And we'll continue to do so if we squabble. Good. I hate Ocon so much. He is so annoying in that car. He just gets in the way. He battles for the sake of battling. Ocon, well, Norris is the quicker car, the quicker driver now on these tyres, but just decides to just get in the way. Oscar's still trapped, by the way. Let's see if we can free him up a little bit here. Up inside. Lovely stuff. Lovely stuff. Why does this always happen? Why, when it makes absolutely no sense, we're the slower car? These guys are like a good way into their stint now. Their tires should be pretty dead. Yeah, they're absolutely flying. Make it make sense. What's going on? What's that line? Why are we going so slow? 1.6 seconds to Ocon on old tires. Defies logic. We're now pit stop behind the Red Bulls. Let's dig Piastri out of some more trouble now. Oh, good. My bad. Look at this train. They've got to get past these Haases. Outside. We get the inside. That should be lovely stuff. E14 it is. We might even get Hülkenberg. Yes. Two for the price of one. Let's go.
Nice.
Can you get the Williams as well? Around the outside. Inside. Hanging in there. Deploy. Oh, we are flying. This is nuts.
Sweet.
Sweet indeed.
Did we just become best friends?
Yep.
It's overtaken three or four cars in the space of 2 minutes. Not even that. Absolutely unbelievable. From Oscar Piastri.
Look at the McLaren here. The gap opens up for them. And Oscar Piastri climbs higher.
He's cooking. That's the best driving I've seen from him all season. That is absolutely incredible. Let's go, mates. Gasly next. We should be flying. 17.8. Way quicker than most people on track. Okay, rain is imminent, so we might as well push now. Try and close the gap. Yeet these tyres. I think the softs are finally falling off. Yeah, it would appear that way. That said, they've been holding on really well. If we were on softs, we wouldn't be holding on as well as the AI, that's for sure. They have an innate ability to stretch tires, but also have incredible pace. Something we can't do. What actually? Oh, in fact, we have broken DRS to Magnussen. 1 minute till rain? Okay, it's happening.
See some light rain.
Yes! Come on, Piastri. Now we make big inroads on Gasly for points. Let's get ready. Chuck these guys on intermediate tyres. This is going to be pretty slow until lap 30. The AI are really going to struggle here. Still a long time until it's ready for wets. Actually, speaking of, do we go straight to wets? Probably not. We may need to go wets around here. Peak confidence for Piastri. Very high for Lando. We are in good position. Really impressed with Oscar. Really impressed. Yellow.
Incident. Exit. Turn. Debris everywhere.
Ooh, there's a safety car. Probably worth boxing. This could change the race.
Sorry, mate.
Where was the crash?
What?
Oh, off. 25 lap old softs and he's overtaking us. I don't know how these guys' tyres haven't died yet. Like I said, we'd have no pace if this is us. Oh, we're closing in on Gasly, though. This could be our moment. Okay, I'm going to stop when it gets to about 0.8 millimeters of rain. Okay, 0.7 now. We're getting pretty close. Pretty close to the crossover. All right. We could box as soon as this lap with Oscar. Magnussen's in. He goes to intermediates. Ocon is, absolutely dying now. The AI are wanting to box now. Slow pit stop. Off they go. Now, we reacted too late in Imola to the rain. I don't want to make the same mistake here. We could get an undercut on Gasly. How long to go? Yeah, I'm going to box Oscar. We're going to do something different to Lando. Let's call him in now. We get the undercut on Gasly. Let's see if this works. It was 2 seconds before. Let's see what it is after. Yeah, we go. Good pit stop. We take those. And free air. Crucially, free air. We're going to wait one more. One more with Lando. The Alpines haven't boxed yet. But Piastri is coming up to AlphaTauri. We're not slower, that's for sure. We're going to stay out one extra lap. Get the RS here. All right, run, run, run. Keep an eye on Piastri. So much going on right now. Piastri's quicker. Let's go. Overall, we're making the right choices. Norris is flying. He's dropped a second to Sainz. Gasly's in as well. Time to find out if the undercut from Piastri has worked. Right now, it's hard to call. It is really hard to call. I think maybe staying out is probably the better choice. As here comes Piastri, there is Gasly. We have, I think, lost time. No, we've gained 4 tenths. 4 tenths gain is what we got. I reckon we box now. Now is the time to box for Inters. I think that was probably the perfect pit lap for Lando.
Okay, yeah, cockpit.
No pit stop issue, good stuff. 2.4, let's go. Hopefully we stay ahead of Ocon. Yeah, well clear. Well clear. Now we're fighting Gasly. Hello. How are we? We'll chill now, we'll save some fuel. Oh, yellow flag.
And we're just going to need to introduce a little bit.
The Ferrari's gone. That could be a safety car.
And here we've got a yellow flag.
Oh no, it's Guanyu Zhou. Okay.
I really did a big mistake.
Disgusting!
Tsunoda finally boxes. No prizes here for guessing what tyre he goes to. Anyone else still out there? Oh, Leclerc is still out there on hards. And is carrying on another lap. Oh my words. Oh my words. Okay. Fair enough, mate. Whatever you say. This is peak Ferrari right here. Leclerc says, is there any weather coming? Ferrari say, we are checking. Sticking their hands out the window. Still checking. Unbelievable. Oh, this is amazing. This is absolutely amazing. Finally boxes. Where is he going to come out in all this? Fortunately, we're too far back to capitalize on that. That time's 20.1, quicker than Leclerc, but he probably made a pit stop. I think we fast forwards. There's not much to do. There's big gaps for those around us. Maybe even partake in some fuel saving activities if the fuel isn't recovering. Norris, I hope, is catching Leclerc. It looks like he is somehow, despite Leclerc having the newest inters in the whole field.
We don't want to overcook the tyres.
Yes, we do.
Confirm.
Rain is only getting heavier, so we can push these ever more. Gasly could get back in the realms of Gasly. Hopefully there's issues for some of the leaders, but we should be pulling clear of Ocon. And Piastri's pulling clear of Alonso, to be fair, doing a great job. Pace on inters is great. This high downforce setup, I guess, is working. We're going to be lapped by Verstappen, so we don't need to worry about fuel too much. Can these tyres do the whole race? Yes, they can. May as well yeet them. Norris still making inroads on Leclerc. Norris won't get lapped, but he's in a better position fuel-wise and under absolutely no threat. So if need be, he can save fuel. Heavy rain potentially in 2 minutes. Let's see. Let's see if it goes to heavy rain. Ah, we lost a bunch of time to Leclerc. He's just flying now. Okay. That was fun while it lasted. Hülkenberg.
So here we go, heading into turn one. And there goes the steering. And they ended up their own passenger.
Cool. 20.0. Let's see if slightly less pushing will help. 20.8. We lose 8 tenths by backing off the pace. 15 laps to go.
Virtual safety car.
Oh.
Drive to the Delta.
What's happened? Is that the... Must be because of... What happens? That'll help the fuel situation, but we're already pretty good for battery. Stroll's out! Oh my words.
Now, this was at turn three. Just flies into that crash. And they'll have to pick themselves up after that.
Hello. Piastri is now in the points. Unlucky, son. Surprised it's not a full-on safety car. Waiting for VSC to go out. Worth a pit stop? No. Tyres are still in good nick. Norris could probably pit and come out in the same position. Oh, we only lose 9 seconds. Safety car or VSC? The pit stop loss, pit lane loss, is 9 seconds. Huge gain to be made if we choose to do so. If only this was a high tyre deck circuit, we would certainly make the most of a VSC pit stop. Guys, should we pit? What's the forecast saying? Light rain in 1 minute, moderate rain in 5 minutes. No way we're catching Leclerc, so might as well. Yeah, all right, let's secure the bag. Chuck some new tyres on for Lando. Ah!
So VSC ending.
Oh, for Christ's sake!
Not much warning. Not much warning indeed. But we come out pretty clearly ahead of Ocon still. Absolutely fine. Most of that was covered in the VSC. But if we get a safety car now, we're looking pretty good. That could have been bad. Oh, what's this?
Mamma mia.
Oh, Piastri could get gassy again. We've yeeted all of our battery. Very close to getting lapped by Verstappen. We will get lapped by Verstappen. It's only a matter of time. Still slower than Leclerc, despite the new tyres. It was worth the gamble, I think, in my opinion. There we go. Verstappen's got us. Come on, do something. Give us a safety car. Nothing going on. 20 seconds to the next car. We just didn't have Leclerc's pace. Holding ground to Alonso quite nicely. Can we make a late charge towards Gasly? He will get lapped by Verstappen any second now. Here he comes. This is where we're going to gain a lot of time back. There we go. Let's Verstappen go. I think that's what we're going to get out of this race, guys. P10, P7. We won't give up with Piastri. Gasly's just been that little bit quicker than us. Good for him to get no more. It'll be good for him to get more points again. We have third time in the points this season. Solid little drive from Oscar. Given where he started. Made some big boy overtakes when it mattered. And has held his own to Alonso this whole race. Very impressive when you consider how good that Aston is. I feel like we lose a lot of time observing blue flags. 3 laps to go. Alonso is closing. At the back end. Last lap for the race leader. We should be okay. We'll back the pace off now. Stay away, Alonso. Get the hell away from me. Look at how much, like, chat always tells me to back off the pace to look after tyre temperatures. But when you stop pushing, you lose so much pace. It's just not worth it. Verstappen wins the Canadian Grand Prix.
Verstappen over the finish line. GG's. And today's winner.
Piastri gets the final points in Canada.
So that's P10.
Consider the beef squashed. At McLaren on that side of the garage. Lando, again, another great drive. Outperforming. Well, maybe not even outperforming the car this weekend. We brought a lot of upgrades, and I thought we'd be closer on pace. But P7 is another handy result. 6 points. 7 overall. There we go. That is the Canadian Grand Prix. In the end, maybe a little bit anticlimactic, that race, in terms of the weather. I thought it would bring a little bit more spice. But it allowed Oscar Piastri to soar from Nowhereville into the top 10. 1 lap down, still a point. That is all that matters. In the drivers, Lando finally eclipses Pierre Gasly and gets inside the top 10. Oscar, another point. Doesn't move any places forwards. Would be nice to get those Haas boys on his front. Constructors, 7 points. We gain 1 on Alpine. This is going to be a grind. A real big grind trying to catch these guys this season. But we're not going to give up. Not by a long shot. We did okay in the pit stops this week. But we are sliding overall. We need to train the pit crew. It's been a while since we've drilled them for better pit stops. We'll bounce back better. 2.9 mil gains overall, which should see us back in the green, because we were pretty dangerously close to going bankrupt again, heading into the race of the Canadian Grand Prix. So, fingers crossed, at the board review, we don't get fired in the next episode of the Austrian Grand Prix. Let's pray for that. Thank you guys so much for watching. Leave a like if you enjoyed. Subscribe to the channel if you're new. To see plenty more F1 Manager content. We're going to keep the pressure on. Try and upgrade as much as we can without getting fired and going over that dreaded cost cap, which is looming over our heads so far. We'll do our best. Thank you so much for watching. Until the next one, I'll see you next time.